eyes on you. Rig this whole mountain with cameras. The center's up ahead. I'm crawling with Peggy's. Be careful. Like I said before, if they spot you, they'll kill our people. So keep out of sight. There's a drain pipe nearby you can use to sneak up on them.
You gotta cover my ass while I meander.
Nice and quiet.
I'm getting my shuffle on over here.
Save our guys the devil's drop.
Please.
I remember that time I kissed a skunk.
Would not want to run into wolves right now.
I should have brought a sweater. It's nippy tonight.
If you leave me here, I'm as good as dead.
Thanks, Deputy. There were more of us.
Fucking Peggy's. I can help. Thanks.
Devil's Drop. You gotta get to Devil's Drop.
Fuck. Depp, they took two of our people up to Devil's Drop. Jacob's on the warpath trying to find a wolf's den. If the Peggy's find us, we don't stand a chance. But if our guys don't give up the location, they'll be tossed off that cliff. All eyes, Depp. Devil's Drop's to the south of you. Outstanding work, Depp. We're gonna take this goddamn mountain back from Jacob. I know it. They're gonna have a lot of angry chatter from the cult. They're calling in chopper convoys to patrol for whitetails. Keep your head on a swivel and eye to the sky.
We got targets!
Nothing like a joyride.
back out there. We can't afford to lose you, too.
Thank you.
Jerky is the Lord's food. Preppers are on.
Seriously?
Step 4, it's all about children. Okay, let's do this.
can't see me, but I can see them. I feel just like the Predator.
The power of all the ships exists. Now there is no flight. Only fight. Judges call the herd.
You're gonna cover my ass while I meander.
The weak and the unworthy. Show no fear. Give yourself over to the Father. Make your sacrifice, and the judges will deem you worthy.
Thanks for saving my ass.
Somebody help me!
There's a lot more of them out there, Depp. If you come across any others, you rescue them, too. Don't let those goddamn Peggies take any more good folk.
Stats. Always was, even back then. Nobody knew it except me. Name's George. I watch the roads for Eli. Let him know what the piggies are up to. Used to be this whole place was filled with kids laughing, playing ball. I'd teach them too. Used to play in the minors, shortstop for the Hope County Cougars. Now that was a long time ago, before this goddamn war. I've been looking through my old cards. Them cult fucks killed our whole damn team. I sworn I had the full set from when I played, but some of them are missing. Say, would you mind keeping your eyes peeled for any of them suckers? Come back when you got them. It'd be great to remind folks of the good old days.
We got Jacob fake scared now. He's gotta deal with the Razizi. Like a joyride.
Hey, goddamn boyfriend with my fishing rod and won't give it back. Help me get it back, would ya? You're packing, right? Shoot a couple holes in his stuff, scare the shit out of him.
What?
Shoot his guitar! You can't even play!
Fuck! Fuck the beer!
It's cheap-ass beer anyway!
On your wall.
I'm gonna my mom always did say, you're full of shit, Dylan.
Oh, God. I think I'm gonna puke. What the fuck? Enough!
Here! Take all your shit! Just don't say I didn't warn you when the cult comes after you! God damn! Everything that cult's been doing around here, I can't believe he thinks the best way to stay alive is to join those fucking psychopaths. He just doesn't get it. I'm trying to get us out of here. See, there's this monster of a fish called the Admiral. Big cash reward for catching it. If I can nab that fish, it's our ticket out of this hellhole. Dylan can be such an idiot. Ugh, I need to clear my head for a bit. Only way I know how is fishing. Why don't you come with me? Could use the company and I'll teach you some angling tricks if you want. Used to go fishing up here with a group from high school. Cooler full of beers and a boat. That's all you need.
They're all gone now.
Either joined up willingly with Eden
or... well, no. Dylan and I are the only ones left.
You coming? Called Widow's Crick. Got his name after some chick drowned her husband. He was, like, a cheating shithead. So, he kind of deserved it. Anyways, see those midges over there? And that splash? It means there's fish begging to be caught. Hey, you got a rod? Give it a go. It's nice down here. Almond. Every time I'm by the water, I almost forget what happened to the rest of this county. Hey, you're good at this. One trick bugger to catch, and I had a thought that it might be easier if we did it together. Even if we split the cash 50-50, it's still more than enough for me and Dylan. So, do you in? But first things first, you gotta up your fishing game. You got some skills, but the Admiral's no joke. If you catch me a fresh sturgeon, I'll know you mean business. I marked some of my favorite fishing spots on your map, but you'll need to grab some special bait. Meet me by the Claggett Boathouse when you're done, and we'll get after the Admiral. Get ready for a fight, though, because that motherfucker, he's got some serious teeth.
How did they know it was so rare? How?
Oh, I'm Dave, by the way. Dave Fowler. Me and Wade ran the Fang Center just up the road. Which, last I heard, is still in the hands of those damn Peggies. Tell you the truth. What are they gonna do with all those bobbleheads? I'll be quick. Tell you the truth, Wade just looks after the animals. I'm the one that actually cares about the merchandise, specifically the cheeseburger bobbleheads. That was all me. And then Jacob came and took pretty much everything. I was lucky to get out with what little I did. But the real issue here is they stole all my cheeseburger bobbleheads. Do you have any idea how valuable those things are? They're friggin' collector items now.
I mean, these things are huge overseas. And they're so rare now, I could make a killing selling them online. Once we can actually get back online, I guess. If you're not sure what they look like, there's one over there on the table. It's the only one they left me. Bastards. Oh my god, you found some. You're amazing. Whatever you do, please find the others.
Thanks, bud.
Just leave a scratch on her. I swear.
Shit!
Watch me, I'm moving!
Hell yeah, crank the tubes. Not that Peggy shit, though.
Nice job. On to the next one. Outside the cabin. Take a look around. Still no luck? It could be some sort of bug-out hole nearby. You know, like a small hatch. Camera. Wait. Ah, no!
motherfuckers looted the place. They're driving away with our shit. Get after them and get that stash back. Hurry! They're getting away!
Watch me, I'm moving!
Thank you.
things in this life than losing a fish.
Nice work. Damn. Glad we can actually put this stuff to use instead of letting it collect dust in some bunker. This is a big help. I can't believe you caught those guys. Thought for sure they'd get away. If we had a couple more people like you around here, Eden's Gate would have rolled over a long time ago. Thanks again, Deputy.
Could just be hunters, but I don't think so. Let's check it out.
No!
Got a job for you. You remember the Grand View Hotel? That shithole we pulled you out of? Need you to head back there. Jacob nabbed a whitetail by the name of Briggs, and he's using the same brain-melting nonsense he tried on you. All in the hopes that Briggs will give up the wolf's den. I don't think our boy can hold out as long as you did. And if he gives up our location, we're done. So we gotta move on this quick. Some folks here think the smart move would be just to off them. But if we start killing our own to save our asses, how's that make us any better than Jacob? Nah, I ain't going down that road. Here's what we're gonna do instead. Weedy's cooked up a little deprogramming package. Same thing we used on you. Need you to swap out the tape they got running in Briggs' room with the one I'm gonna give you. And then, well, then we'll see what happens. If everything goes smooth, our guy comes back to Earth. If it doesn't, well, we'll deal with that when the time comes.
Haven't had to pay for gas since them Peggy's went apeshit.
I probably have the biggest...
Hey, you got a sec? So, here's the deal. I'm trying to get this pirate radio running. Something to inspire the troops. Get people on our side, you know? And before anyone tries talking shit, yeah, I prefer vinyl. But don't you call me a fucking hipster, though. Ain't gonna catch me wearing a man bun or drinking kombucha. Our radio signal's shot right now, but Tammy's on that. In the meantime, I figured I should start working on the playlist. Eli left a couple records for me, but I could always use more. So, if you happen to come across any albums, toss them my way. Once Tammy gets the signal clear, it's DJ Weedy 24/7. Hope you're ready.
Wonder if we'll get this clusterfuck tied up in time for the chili cook-off.
Hawkeye here.
Cool. These babies are going on the air pronto. You come across any more, I'll add them to the playlist.
Make sure you're armed. We don't want to lose no one to this.
Just wanted to call and check in with you boys. We're still doing our thing.
I heard a rat the other day.
Dutch out.
Hey there, girl.
Ah, shit! He's coming for you again, kid! You better be careful!
Those hunters could be anywhere.
Steps 1, 2, and 3 are fuck shit up. Step 4, it's all about chill. Okay, let's do this!
Hope you don't get vertigo. That'll do it. Next tower's northeast. It's on a cliff overlooking the hotel. If you got a wingsuit, now's the time to use it. Just try not to crash.
One of you will be strong.
Not again.
Yeah, you're peaches.
I know you were in pain. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh. You're not the only one to be tested. Did you know that I had a wife? So beautiful, isn't she? We were pregnant with our first child. And we were just babies ourselves, really. And I was terrified of becoming a father, mostly about money. She wasn't worried. She had faith that things were gonna work out. She always had faith. And one day she was gonna go visit a friend. It was an accident. The Lord take it. They rushed me to a hospital and put me in a room with this little pink bundle stuffed with tubes. And they said that I had to be strong because my little girl was gonna live. God was looking out for our daughter. And they left me alone in the room with her. I just stared at my daughter, so helpless, so innocent. When all she had in the world was me, when nobody from nowhere was thought. And in that moment, I knew that God was testing me. He was laying out a path before me, and all I had to do was choose. So I put my hand on my little girl's head. And I leaned in and I could smell her. And we prayed together. Prayed for wisdom. Prayed for strength. damaged and shut. And after a little while, their legs began to kick in. Stillness, release, the Lord giveth and the Lord. Take pain, sacrifice, these are all part of his test. And we have to prove that we can serve God, no matter what he asks.
Not bad.
deputy? Seelai. Just checking in. Nobody's seen you in a while. Whitetails could really use your help out there. Pop by the wool stand if you get the chance. We got a lot of work to do. Station, Depp. That's great news. Colt can't train there anymore. Hell, now we got a damn good view of our land.
In the weeks leading up to May 10th, 1971, Plush Nixon, the greatest stuntman in the known universe, consumed massive quantities of cigarettes, raw eggs, whiskey, and wolf testosterone, the latter of which was injected directly into his tear ducts. Clutch credited this balanced diet as the reason he survived the punishing mountainside race known as Quadzilla. Clutch went to bed that night with a partially dislocated coccyx and the warm comfort of knowing that his stunt would never be repeated.
Good taking over the radar station, but it's not over. Looks like they're still broadcasting data from here. Best way to take it down is to destroy their satellite dishes. Pretty sure I saw three of them on the rooftops around here. Take some explosives and blow them to hell. Better hurry up. I'm pretty sure they already know we're here.
all the animals, but I think Cheeseburger is still loose.
Gonna get someone killed. Good thing I called. That could have been messy, huh? Sorry about that. I should have double-checked before I sent you out. That was my fault. But you did good work. Got enough of the bliss-infused samples. That's what we needed. I've had time to tweak the formula, and now it's rock solid. As soon as it finishes processing, you'll have a new batch waiting. I can't thank you enough for all you've done around here, Deputy. Sheriff said you were good, but I didn't think you were this good. Thank you.
I got a serious problem. Could really use your help. You did good here. Saved a lot of people. Thanks. Thing is, I know these fuckers. They're like clockwork. The trucks they send to pick up the next bunch of recruits are already on their way. I want to set up a little welcome party when they come through the front gates. We're gonna blow those trucks sky high so they'll never use them again. Whatever we do, can't let them get away.
Thank you.
Thanks for the help. Hold on, I'm coming down.
Fuckers came out of nowhere. You're no good to be dead. How the hell are these things so strong? Shit, I didn't think I was gonna make it. Thanks for that. I'm Sarah, by the way, Sarah Perkins. Was heading up a wildlife conservation team studying the wolves in the park, and then, well, we found these things. They're wolves, but not like anything I've seen before. The cult calls them judges. Bigger, stronger, tougher than the other species around here. The cult tried to force my team to help him. When we said no, they sicked those things on us. Eli and the Whitetails got me out. Been trying to pay them back ever since. I've got a theory on how to use the cult's formula to help us track these creatures. But all I'm working with is corpses. I need a live judge. I know it's a big ask, but I'm desperate. The cult's training him at an old youth camp called the Breakthrough. Do this for me, and I might be able to put something together that'll help you hunt these things. I'll meet you at the camp once it's clear.
Thank you. one guy with a gun. How hard can it be?
Backup's on its way. It should be there any minute now.
Deputy, I gotta tell you, some of the whitetails, well, some of them weren't so sure about bringing you on board. They're sure now. Not because of anything I said, but because of what you've done. Actions speak louder than words. People are coming from all over to join the whitetails. You're giving them hope again. It's been a long time coming, yep. A long time. We'll be right back.